Hello all, welcome back students. Let us continue ahead with the next topic of this chapter, polynomials. As you can see, today we are going to see a very important topic, that is relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. Before we move ahead with this topic, let us have a quick revision from class, that is what is zero and what is the meaning of coefficient of any given polynomial. Now, what is zero of a polynomial? It is that value of x at which the value of entire polynomial becomes zero. I repeat, what is zero of a polynomial? It is that value of x at which the entire polynomial p of x becomes zero. Yesterday we saw two methods to find out zero of any given polynomial. First was algebraic method and second was graphical method. Now let us come back to the point of what is a coefficient. Students, remember yesterday we saw three different types of polynomials. First was linear. What was the general equation? Ax plus b. Then we saw quadratic. What was the general equation? Ax square plus bx plus c. And lastly, yesterday we saw cubic polynomial. What was the general equation? Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Now students, just make and pay attention here. Here variables are x to the power 2, that is x square, x to the power 3, x cube, x square, x. These are the variables. Now you can see along with each variable, there is a constant term attached. As you can see that I am circling, along with each variable, there is a constant term attached. These constant terms are actually called coefficients. I repeat, along with each variable, there is a constant term attached. These constant terms are called coefficients. Now we have three more things, that is in linear equation we have ax plus b, in quadratic we have ax square plus bx plus c, in cubic we have ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So these values b, c and d can also be called constants because they are not having any variable. So I repeat before proceeding ahead with today's topic. Zero. What is zero of a polynomial? It is that value of x at which the polynomial p of x equation becomes zero. Yesterday we saw two methods to find out zero of a polynomial, that is algebraic method and graphical method. Second is coefficient. Any constant term attached to any given variable in this kind of polynomials can be called coefficients. Students, today's class will be divided into three major parts. We will see the relation between zeros and coefficients for linear polynomial, that is case 1. We will see relation between zeros and coefficients for quadratic polynomial, that will be our case number 2 for today. And finally, we will see relationship between zeros and coefficients for a cubic polynomial, that will be our case number 3 for today. Okay students, so now let us see case number 1 for establishing relationship between zeros and coefficients of a polynomial. Case number 1 will be for a simple linear polynomial. Let us take a simple example. Say p of x equal to 4x plus 3. We have taken a simple linear polynomial, that is 4x plus 3. Now, using yesterday's algebraic method, how we will find zero of this polynomial? We will suppose the equation 4x plus 3 is 0. X will be equal to minus 3 by 4. This is the zero of the polynomial, right? Using yesterday's method. Now, let us quickly establish a relationship with the zeros and the coefficients. Students, we should not forget the general form of a linear polynomial is Ax plus b. So, let us compare this equation and try to find out the zero or the relationship between zero and coefficient. Let us say x equal to, because here minus is there, I will put a minus. What is 3? 3 is this constant term. So I will write constant. upon, what is this 4? 4 is coefficient of x. So I will write coefficient of x. Or what is this constant term, students? This constant term is b. What is this coefficient of x? Coefficient of x is a. So what relation do we have for linear polynomial and its zero? X, that is the zero of the polynomial, is equal to minus b upon a. And we should never forget how this minus b and a are coming. They are coming from the general form of this linear polynomial, that is ax plus b, where a is the coefficient of the variable that is given and b is the constants. So zero of a linear polynomial can be easily find out by x equal to minus b upon a, where minus b is the constant and a is the coefficient of the variable. Let us do a very simple example to find out the zero of the polynomial. Suppose we have a linear equation p of x equal to 11x plus 9. Now we know the formula to find out the zero of the polynomial directly, x equal to minus b by a. Just initially comparing this equation with the general form, 11x plus 9 can be compared to ax plus b. So students, what is b? Minus 9. What is a? 11. So zero of this polynomial will be minus 9 upon 11. Let us very quickly take one more example to make our understanding concrete. Let us suppose we have a linear polynomial, say 25x plus 12. So what is the zero of the polynomial? Minus b upon a. What is b? 12. So this will be minus 12. What is a? 25. In this way, we can easily find out the zero of a polynomial for a linear polynomial. I again repeat, what is the, you can say, formula or method to find out the zero of a linear polynomial? X, that is zero of the linear polynomial, is equal to minus b upon a. Students, before proceeding ahead to case number 2, let us see a simple variation. Suppose I have a linear polynomial px equal to 2x minus 3. Now we are told to that we need to find the zero of this polynomial. Now just now we saw the method. What was the method? Zero of a polynomial is equal to minus b by a. X, that is zero of polynomial, equal to minus. Now we will have a confusion that if we compare this equation 2x minus 3 with the general form, that is ax plus b. Generally, every student might have a confusion that what value of b has to be taken? Has it to be 3 or has it to be minus 3? So it is very simple. We will always follow the general form of a linear equation. What is that? Ax plus b. So this equation in the form of general form of a linear polynomial can be 2x plus minus 3. Then only it easily matches with our, you can say, general form of the linear polynomial. So students, value of b will not be plus 3, it will be minus 3. So x equal to minus b by a, x equal to minus, what is the value of b? Minus 3. What is the value of a? 2. So finally, what zero of this polynomial we are getting? 3 upon 2. Okay students, there is also a very shortcut method to check whether our answer, that is zero of a polynomial, is actually correct or not. Remember, yesterday we saw a small topic, that is value of a polynomial. To check whether this answer is correct or not, what we will do? We will actually take our original equation polynomial 2x minus 3. What was the zero of the polynomial that we obtained? 3 upon 2. So we will place the value of 3 upon 2 here and we will see that the final answer is coming 0. If this is happening, that means p of x is actually becoming 0 and our answer is actually correct. Let us see one more example to clarify our any doubts if we are having. Suppose we have a linear polynomial, say 7x minus 12. We are told to find the zero of this polynomial. Simple. What is the formula? X, that is zero of the polynomial, equal to minus b by a. As we saw in the previous sum, minus will be here. What is the value of b here? It is not plus 12, but it is actually minus 12. What is the value of a? 7. What is the zero of the polynomial that we are getting? 12 upon 7. Let us quickly verify our answer just in case. 7x minus 12 was our, you can say, original polynomial. What zero we obtained? 12 upon 7. Placing the value of x to be 12 upon 7, what we are getting? 7 eliminated, and 12 minus 12 will be 0. That means our answer is actually correct. Okay students, let us move to the second case for today. Remember, we are studying the topic, that is relationship between zeros and coefficients. We just saw case number 1, that is relation for linear polynomial. Now we are going to see case number 2, that is quadratic polynomial. Students, we should remember, what is the general form of a quadratic polynomial? It is p of x equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a should not be equal to 0. Now, remember yesterday's session video, students, how many maximum zeros can a linear polynomial have? It was 1. How many maximum zeros can a quadratic polynomial have? It was 2. And how many maximum zeros can a cubic polynomial have? It was 3. And it was all based on the number of degrees of each given polynomial. So students, a quadratic polynomial will have maximum 2 zeros. So let us suppose that let alpha and beta be the zeros of the above given quadratic polynomial p of x. So if alpha and beta are the zeros of this given quadratic polynomial, then there exists a relation. That is, first relation is sum of zeros. What are the zeros, students? Alpha and beta. So first relation can be alpha plus beta equal to minus coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Now this can also be written in a very simple format. Minus, what is coefficient of x? B upon coefficient of x square. What is coefficient of x square? A. Students, we have the first relation for sum of zeros. Remember, the zeros are alpha and beta. So alpha plus beta can be minus b upon a, where b is the coefficient of x, a is the coefficient of x square. Because alpha and beta are two zeros, we have one more relation, that is product of zeros. Now if sum was a plus b, what will be product? Alpha into beta. Now what is the relation we are having? We are having constant upon coefficient of x square. It can also be written as, students, just pay attention, what is the constant here? Constant is c. What is the coefficient of x square here? Coefficient of x square is a. So what is the product of zeros? Alpha into beta equal to c upon a. So these are the two main relations for you can say quadratic polynomial. If quadratic polynomial is having two zeros, alpha and beta, we have two relation: sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta equal to minus b upon a. What is b? It is coefficient of x. What is a? It is coefficient of x square. Second relation is product of zeros, that is alpha into beta, that is c upon a. What is c? It is actually the constant term. And what is a? It is the coefficient of x square. Okay students, so based on what we just learned for a quadratic polynomial, that it has two zeros, alpha and beta, and there are two relations between its zeros, that is sum of zeros, that we can easily see sum of zeros is minus b upon a, and product of zero is c upon a. So let us do a simple sum so that we can test both the relations for a quadratic polynomial. As you can see the question, this kind of questions are asked in the textbook. Find all zeros of quadratic polynomial. What is the quadratic polynomial? P of x equal to x square plus 7x plus 10. And also verify the relationship between its zeros. So I will write this equation. P of x equal to x square plus 7x plus 10. Now remember students, what we just did for a linear polynomial to find out the zero. Just a small example of a linear polynomial. Suppose we have a linear polynomial 7x plus 3. What was the formula to find the zero? Zero was x equal to minus b upon a. So what we were keeping? B was 3, so minus 3 upon 7. This was the method how which we find out the zero for the linear polynomial. But as you can see students, there is no such method to find out the zero of a polynomial directly in case of a quadratic polynomial. So what we can do? We can go back to 9th standard where we learned about splitting the middle term method. So I will write the equation. X square plus 7x plus 10. Now on splitting the middle term, what we will do? We will split 7x into 5 and 2. That is plus 5x plus 2x plus 10. X is common, so we are getting x plus 5. 2 is common, so again we are getting x plus 5. So what we are finally getting? X plus 2 and x plus 5 as the factors. Now, because we need to find out the zero of the polynomial, what we will do? We will suppose these factors x plus 2 and x plus 5 are equal to 0. Now, students, if x plus 2 is equal to 0, what is the first zero we are obtaining? We are obtaining it to be minus 2. Again, if x plus 5 is again equal to 0, what is the second zero we are obtaining? We are obtaining it to be minus 5. So, what are the two zeros that we obtained for this sum? X is minus 2 and x is minus 5. Now do not forget, we just discussed a few moments back that if the two zeros of a quadratic polynomial are there, those zeros will be alpha and beta. So our first zero is minus 2, second zero is minus 5. So let us suppose that alpha, that is the first zero, is minus 2 and beta, that is the second zero, is minus 5. So here we have obtained both the zeros of this quadratic polynomial, that is alpha and beta. Alpha is minus 2, beta is minus 5. Students, do not forget, we have only found out the zeros of the polynomial, but the question is still incomplete. The last part of the question is, also verify the relationship between its zeros. So I hope we can solve it there. What were the two relationships we obtained? First was sum of zeros, alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. Second relationship was product of zeros, alpha into beta equal to c upon a. Let us see, alpha plus beta, what is alpha? Minus 2 plus, what is beta? Minus 5. Minus 2, minus 5, what we are getting this side? Minus 7. Let us see the opposite side, what is in the opposite side? That is minus b by a, so minus. We will go into the question back and just compare it with the general form. What was the general form of the quadratic polynomial? Ax square plus bx plus c. So as per that, we need the value of b. What is the value of b? 7 upon. We need the value of a. Here nothing is there. Nothing is there means what is there? 1. What is the value of a? 1. So we are getting to be minus 7. So the first relationship is verified, sum of zeros, that is minus b upon a, we are getting minus 7 on both the sides, that means this relationship is true. Let us go for the second relationship, that is product of zeros, alpha into beta equal to c upon a. What is the value of alpha? Minus 2 into, what is the value of beta? Minus 5, and as we know that minus 2 into minus 5 will be 10. C by a, what is the value of c? We are getting C by A, what is the value of C as per the general form? C is 10. What is the value of A? It is 1. So we are getting 10 on both the sides. That means product of 0, alpha into beta equal to C upon A is also verified. So students, this is a basic type of question that can be asked for quadratic polynomial. Polynomial can be given. We have to find out the zeros and also verify the relationship. What we did using the splitting method as per 9th standard, we found out x plus 2 and x plus 5. Now because we need to find out the zeros, we compared and both of them with 0, we were getting x equal to minus 2, x equal to minus 5. Both the zeros are available. Now because the zeros of quadratic polynomial are called alpha and beta, we took alpha to be minus 2, we took beta to be minus 5. Finally, we verified the relationship between both the thing relations available. Alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a, alpha into beta is equal to c by a. And as you can see, both the relationships are actually verified. Okay, students, let us proceed ahead. In the previous sum, we saw that we were given a quadratic polynomial and we need to find the zeros of the polynomial, which we actually did by splitting the middle term, and also we verified the relationship. Now, there can be one more kind of question where actually zeros of quadratic polynomial are given and we need to actually find the quadratic polynomial. So, let us see a simple example regarding that. Suppose we have a quadratic polynomial with a relationship of zeros as alpha plus beta. Suppose we are taking minus 3. And second relationship, product of zeros, alpha into beta. Suppose we are taking 2. And now we need to find the actual quadratic polynomial whose relationship between zeros are alpha plus beta is minus 3. And alpha into beta is 2. Remember, in the previous question, we were given quadratic polynomial. We were finding the zeros and establishing or verifying the relationship between them. In this question, we are already given the relationship between zeros of a quadratic polynomial and we need to actually find that quadratic polynomial. So, how we will start? Let us say first we will write the general form of a quadratic polynomial. So, what is that? Ax square plus bx plus C. Now, we know the relationship between both the zeros of a quadratic polynomial. First relation was sum of 0. What was that? Sum of 0 was minus b by a. Now, if we just see above, what is sum of 0? Alpha plus beta, it is equal to minus 3. So, can we write minus b by a equal to minus 3? So, if minus b by a is equal to minus 3, minus minus will be eliminated on both the sides, and what we are getting? B equal to 3a. This can be our equation number 1 for a while. What was the second relation? Alpha into beta, that is product of zeros, equal to c by a. What is alpha into beta given in the question? 2. So, if we are writing c upon a equal to 2, what can be the second equation? C equal to 2a. Now, as we can see, this is equation number 2. As we can see, both the equations B equal to 3a and C equal to 2a are actually dependent and based on a. So, now let us see what we can do. I will again write the relations once more. B equal to 3a, C equal to 2a. Both the relations are actually based on a and we need to find out the quadratic polynomial. So, what we can do, if value of a is 1, if I put 1 here, what will be the value of b? 3. What will be the value of c if I just put 1 here? C will be 2. If this is the case, if a is 1. If I am taking value of a to be 2, if a is 2, we will just orally do this. If the value of a is 2, what will be b? 3 into 2, 6. If value of a is 2, what will be c? 2 into 2, 4. Let us take the last case. If value of a is 3, if value of a is actually 3, if I just place 3 here, 3 into 3 will be 9. If I just place 3 here, 3 into 2 will be 6. Let us form the equations. We should not forget what is the general form, ax square plus bx plus c. A is 1, so x square, b is 3, plus 3x, and c is 2, plus 2, so this is our first equation. If a is 2, we can say that a is 2, so 2x square, b is 6, plus 6x, c is 4, that is plus 4. If a is 3, what will be the equation? 3x square plus 9x plus 6. Students, do you find any peculiarity or relationship between all the three equations? X square plus 3x plus 2, 2x plus 2x square plus 6x plus 4, 3x square plus 9x plus 6. Yes, you can see all the three equations are multiples of each other. So, how we can write the general equation or the general quadratic polynomial? It can be P of x equal to k x square plus 3x plus 2. Now you might be wondering, what is k? K is a constant. Here k can be taken to be 1. Here you can see we can take 2 common, so k can be taken to be 2. Here we can see that 3 can be taken as common and k can be taken to be 3. So this is the general equation of a quadratic polynomial. Okay students, so let us go for the last case for today, that is case number 3 for cubic polynomial. As you can see, I have written the general equation of a cubic polynomial, that is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Now, what did we discuss? How many maximum zeros can a cubic polynomial have? Yeah, it is 3. How many maximum zeros can a quadratic polynomial have? 2. So that is why we took the zeros of quadratic polynomial to be alpha and beta. Now, there are 3 zeros possible maximum for a cubic polynomial. So, let zeros be alpha, beta, and we are adding one more zero, that is gamma. Alpha, beta, and gamma. Now, for quadratic polynomial, we had two relationship, that is sum of zeros, alpha plus beta, and product of zeros, alpha into beta. For a cubic polynomial, we can have three relationships, that is first is sum of zeros, it is very simple, alpha plus beta plus gamma, that is equal to minus coefficient of x square upon coefficient of x cube. Students, what is coefficient of x square? B. What is coefficient of x cube? A. So, we have the first relation, sum of zeros alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus B upon A. Now, let us go for the second relation. This is one different type of relation. It is sum of product of zeros. Sum of product of zeros. So what we will do here, we will write alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus alpha into gamma. As you can see, we have taken all the three zeros, their products, and we have done the sum of that. Alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus alpha into gamma. So this is equal to, we can say, coefficient of x upon coefficient of x cube. So students, what is coefficient of x? As you can see, coefficient of x is c. What is coefficient of x cube? As you can see, coefficient of x cube is a. So what is the equation? C upon a. So we have the second relation, alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus alpha into gamma is equal to C upon A. And this is the second relation, that is sum of product of zeros. Now, third relation is very simple. It is product of zeros. Now, what is product of zeros? Alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus constant term upon coefficient of x cube. Students, what is the constant term? Constant term is d. What is coefficient of x cube? Coefficient of x cube is a. So what we are getting? Minus d upon a. So students, third relation, product of zeros, alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d upon a. So these are the three relations possible for a cubic polynomial. Sum of zeros, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a, that is coefficient of x square upon coefficient of x cube. Sum of product of zeros, alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus alpha into gamma is equal to c upon a, that is coefficient of x upon coefficient of x cube. And product of zeros, that is alpha into beta into gamma, equal to minus d upon a, that is minus constant divided by coefficient of x cube. Okay, now let us solve a question based on cubic polynomial. Here we have a question, p of x, that is a polynomial, 3x cube minus 5x square minus 11x minus 3. We have to verify whether 3, minus 1 and minus 1 by 3 are actually the zeros of this given polynomial. Once it is verified, we will also verify the relationship between the zeros of this cubic polynomial. What was the relationship? Alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus alpha gamma equal to c by a. And alpha into beta into gamma equal to minus d by a. So let us start. P of x equal to 3x cube minus 5x square minus 11x minus 3. Remember the previous question that we solved, we had to split the quadratic equation so as to get the zeros. But there is no need to do such things. We are already been given the zeros. We just need to verify whether it is actually the zero of this equation. So what is the meaning of zero of a polynomial? It is that value of x which makes the entire polynomial zero. So what we will do? We will check whether all these three values are actually the zero of the given polynomial p of x. How we will do? Let us see. P of 3, we will replace the value of 3 in the above equation. 3 square minus 11, 3 minus 3. 3 cube is 27. 5 square is 9, 3 square is 9. It will be 81 minus 45. Minus 33 minus 3. Now on solving, minus 45 minus 33 minus 3 will be 81. So 81 minus 81 is 0. So this is actually the 0 of the above given equation. Now let us verify it for the second value, that is the second 0, that is P of minus 1. Putting the value of minus 1 in the above equation, is 1 cube minus 1 square minus 1 minus 3. Minus 1 cube will be minus 1, so this will be minus 3. Minus 1 square will be 1, so minus 5. Minus minus will be plus 11 minus 3. Minus 8 plus 11 minus 3, 8. Again, this answer is also 0. So minus 1 is also actually 0 of the given polynomial. Let us solve it for the third 0. The value is minus 1 by 3. So minus 1 by 3 whole cube minus 5 minus 1 by 3 whole square minus 11 minus 1 by 3 minus 3. So this will be minus 1 upon 27 minus 1 upon 3 whole square will be minus this 1 upon 9. This will be 11 upon 3 minus 3. 3 and 27 will be eliminated. So we are left with minus 1 upon 9 minus 5 upon 9 plus 11 upon 3 minus 3. Taking the LCM, definitely LCM will be 9. So here we are getting minus 1 minus 5 plus 33 minus 27. So on solving, minus 5 minus 1 minus 6. 33 minus 27 plus 6 upon 9. So finally, we are getting 0. So minus 1 upon 3 is also the one of the zeros of the given cubic polynomial. So now students, as we have verified that all the three zeros were actually the correct zeros of the polynomial. So three zeros are there. Alpha is 3, beta is minus 1, now gamma is minus 1 by 3. Now let us verify the relationship between all these zeros. What was the first relation? Alpha plus beta plus gamma should be equal to minus b upon a. And for simplicity, we will write this equation in the general form. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Remember the minus signs when you are taking the value in the verification. So let us verify the first value. Alpha is 3, beta is minus 1, gamma is minus 1 upon 3. So taking the LCM, LCM is here bound to be 3. So this will be 9, this will be 3, and this will be 1. So 3 minus 9 minus 3 is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5. So we are getting this side 5 upon 3. Let us check the other side, minus b upon a. So first we will write minus. Let us go back and just see what is the value of b. Here it is minus 5. So minus of minus 5. And what is the value of a? Value of a is 3. So 3. Minus minus will become plus. So first relationship is verified. We are getting 5 upon 3 on both the sides. Now, let us go for the second relation. What was the second relation? It was the sum of products. So let me write the relation alpha beta plus beta gamma plus alpha gamma should be equal to C upon A. So let us place the values of this alpha into beta. 3 into minus 1 will be minus 3 plus beta into gamma minus 1 into minus 1 upon 3 will be 1 upon 3 and alpha into gamma 3 into minus 1 by 3, 3 3 will be cut, we are left with minus 1. Minus 3 minus 1 will be minus 4 plus 1 upon 3. On solving we are getting LCM as 3, this will be minus 12 plus 1, so finally this side we are getting minus 11 upon 3. Let us check the other side. Other side is of C upon A. What is the value of C? It is minus 11. So, minus 11. What is the value of A? It is 3. So, this side also we are getting minus 11 upon C and minus 11 upon 3. So, second relation, that is alpha beta plus beta gamma plus alpha gamma equal to C by A is also verified. Now let us verify the last relation, that is products of the zeros alpha into beta into gamma is equal to minus d upon a. Now what is the value of alpha? 3. What is the value of beta? Minus 1. What is the value of gamma? It is minus 1 upon 3. On eliminating we are getting 1. Let us verify it for minus d by a. Students, you can see value of d is minus 3. So, minus of minus 3, value of a is 3. So, divided by 3, minus minus will be plus, 3 upon 3 will be 1. So, as you can see students, all the three relations have been verified correctly. Okay, students, now let us solve one sum from the exercise. I have taken exercise 2.2. First question, second. Now what we have to do for these questions, we have to find out the zeros and also verify the relationship between the zeros. Now as you can see, this is a type of quadratic polynomial. Do not forget students, for quadratic polynomial, we are using factorization method to find out the zeros. So we have 4s square minus 4s plus 1. Now if you see, this is in the form of a minus b whole square. So what is the solution we are getting? 2s minus 1 whole square. Now because this is we are finding zeros of the polynomial, we will compare p of x equal to 2s minus 1. We are assuming this to be 0. 2s minus 1 whole square equal to 0. This means what? 2s minus 1, 2s minus 1 equal to 0. That means we are getting first 0 to be 1 by 2. We are also getting second 0 to be 1 by 2. So, our alpha in this case will be 1 by 2, that is first 0. Our beta in this case will also be 1 by 2. Now, let us quickly verify the relationship. What was the first relation for this quadratic? Alpha plus beta equal to minus b upon a. And alpha into beta equal to c upon a. For simplicity, we are writing the equation here, so it is easy for us to judge. Ax square plus bx plus c. Do not forget the minus sign. Now, what is alpha plus beta? Say 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2, that will be equal to 2 upon 2, that will be equal to 1. Let us say minus b by a. So, we will keep minus. What is the value of b? We can say minus 4. What is the value of a? We can say 4. So minus minus 4 plus minus will be eliminated. 4 upon 4 will be 1. So students, as you can see, the first relationship is actually verified. Let us go for the second relationship. Alpha into beta, that is 1 upon 2 into 1 upon 2. What we are getting? 1 upon 4. Very simple. C. What is the value of C? 1. What is the value of A? 4. So both sides we are getting 1 upon 4. So this is how the relation is actually verified. Okay, now let us see a question from question 2 of the same exercise 2.2. Here what we have to do, students, we have been given sum of 0 and product of 0 of a quadratic equation. We have to actually find or frame that quadratic equation. Remember previously in the same video we had done same kind of question where sum of the zeros were given and we were finding the equation. But in this case we are given sum of zeros and product of zeros and we need to find the quadratic equation. So sum of 0 is root 2. So let us write alpha plus beta equal to root 2 and product of zeros is 1 upon 3. Alpha into beta equal to 1 upon 3. Although we can use the traditional method for this kind of sums, but there exists one shortcut method by which we can easily solve such kind of questions and find out the quadratic equation. So the general form of such equations or shortcut method of such equation is x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha into beta. I repeat, students, although we can follow the method that we just discussed in this video before, but this is a shortcut method by which if sum of zeros and product of zeros are given, we can directly find the quadratic equation or the polynomial using this small formula, that is x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha into beta. Now let us place the values. X square minus, what is alpha plus beta? Root 2. So we will write root 2x plus alpha into beta, that is 1 upon 3. Now we can see that this polynomial is of the form where we are involving a rational number. Remember, try to eliminate these rational numbers. How we will do? To eliminate these rational numbers, we will multiply the entire equation by 3. Why we are multiplying by 3? Just as to eliminate this rational number. So on multiplying, we are getting 3x square minus 3 root 2x plus 3 upon 3. So finally, we are getting 3x square minus 3 root 2x plus 3 upon 3 will be 1. So this is our required quadratic polynomial. I repeat what we did. We were given the sum of zeros and product of zeros. We wrote down the relations. Although we can follow the older method, but there is a shortcut. The shortcut general equation for such kind of questions where we need to find the polynomials or the quadratic polynomial is x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha into beta. Just placing the values, and for eliminating this rational one, we are multiplying by 3. So what answer we are getting? 3x square minus 3 root 2x plus 1. So now rest of the sums of exercise 2.2, that is both the questions first and second, will be solved by you. Further doubts will be discussed in the coming sessions. Thank you and have a nice day.